everybody. So today I'm really, really glad to be back. It's been a very long time that I haven't filmed. So yeah, I'm really happy to be back today. So I already did my base. So I already applied my Smashbox primer and my MAC foundation. So now I'm starting off by priming my eyes using my Paint Pots by MAC. So then I'm just taking any kind of really light eyeshadow, the same color than my Soft Ochre Paint Pot, just to fix it in place and make sure that everything stays on and all the shadows that I'm gonna apply later will apply smoothly. So now I'm taking just a light brown eyeshadow. It doesn't matter the brand or anything, just take a light brown eyeshadow and you place it in your crease. So you're just gonna take a blending brush and just blend the shadow in your crease to define your eyes and make them look bigger and so just blend. So now I'm taking my Makeup Geek Void eyeshadow in Showtime, and today I'm going for a halo kind of makeup look. So it means that I'm gonna place this dark color on the outer corner of my eyes but also in the inner corners, and I'm just gonna leave the middle of my lid blank, and I'm gonna put a very, very light and shiny eyeshadow on later. So that's called an halo effect. And so you just place your dark color on the outer and inner corners of your eyes and you just blend very, very well with your light brown, and you make sure that everything looks smooth. So now, as I said earlier, I'm taking a more shiny and light color that I'm placing just on the middle part of my lid so that it gives this really halo beautiful effect, and this is the Makeup Geek Foil eyeshadow in the Spotlight. Next, I'm taking my liner from L'Oreal and I'm just doing a very, very tiny, super, super thin line because I don't want to make a cat eye or anything. I just want to define my eyes a little bit so it will make them bigger and just looking better, but I don't want a super big cat eye or anything. I just want a really, really thin line. So then you just tightline your upper lash line to make sure that there is no flesh color left. And I personally, I'm going to apply false lashes, but it's really not necessary. If you just want to put mascara on, that's more than enough and it will look super ready too, but I just felt like putting some lashes on. So now I am going to finish my face makeup, so I'm just putting my concealer on my T-zone, then I'm gonna powder and contour and put some blusher and highlighter, and you know, always the same, always the same.
Flashlights when we're falling into that night. Focused on what you feel just when you were calling a love that died. And we were bound to the city life. Flashlights when we're falling into that night. Focused on what you feel just when you were calling.
So then for the last part on my eyes, just to finish off everything, I'm taking a bit of my light brown color that I took earlier with, and I'm mixing it with my Makeup Geek Coco Bear eyeshadow, and I'm just applying this on the lower lash line of my eyes to define my eyes even more, and always the same, you know, to make them look a bit bigger and deeper, and you know, to make your eye colors pop more, all that stuff. Next, for the lips, I wanted something not really nude but still on the more lighter side, so I'm just taking my MAC lip liner in Soar, and then I'm gonna take my lip tint by Sephora, and it's number 13, and I am just applying this on my lips, and then the look will be complete.
Even if I wanted to, and I can't change. Even if I try, my love, my love, my love, she keeps me warm. She keeps me warm. She keeps me warm. My love, my love, my love, she keeps me warm. She keeps me warm.
So there you have, guys, the finished look. I really hope you liked it. It's a really simple but still pretty looking and fresh looking, and I don't know, I've never done this halo effect before, but I really like it. So yeah, I hope you liked it. If you did, then please subscribe to my channel and give a thumbs up, and I'll see you in my next video. Thank you, bye.